We get to see Chris Pratt's butt in this movie. How can it get better than that? Passengers is a sci-fi romance drama directed by Morten Tilden, starring Chris Pratt and Jennifer Lawrence. It's about this ship called the Avalon that's headed towards a new home called Homestead 2. And on board are 5,000 passengers who are asleep and supposed to be asleep for the duration of the 120 years. Two characters named Jim and Aurora, played by Chris Pratt and Jennifer Lawrence, end up waking up 90 years earlier than they're supposed to do. So while they're faced with this impending doom because they can't go back to sleep, they end up falling for each other. Along the way, they find out that there's something wrong with the Avalon, and they're the only two people that can save everyone on board, including themselves. I was genuinely so excited for Passengers. I think it was probably one of my most anticipated movies for the rest of the year, if not my most anticipated movie. And that's because I love Chris Pratt, as I'm sure you all know by now. And also, I just thought the premise of this movie was really promising, and it sounded really interesting. Unfortunately, this isn't my favorite movie of the year like I was hoping it would be, and I wanted it to be this amazing sci-fi romantic epic that everyone loves, but it's been getting kind of mixed reviews, and I do see why. However, I don't think it's as bad as the reviews are saying it is, because honestly, I did have a good time with it, and I enjoyed a majority of the movie. However, it's not this amazing movie that I really wanted to see, but it's also not terrible. First off, the acting is without a doubt amazing in this movie. Chris Pratt and Jennifer Lawrence had this really hard task of basically carrying the entire movie. Michael Sheen plays this android who's like a bartender, and they kind of befriend him along the way, but he isn't really a main character, and he's also not human. So it's really only Chris Pratt and Jennifer Lawrence that we have to follow throughout the movie, and if they weren't charismatic or likable, then the movie would just be bad. But luckily, they both are just really great. In particular, I really enjoyed Chris Pratt's acting, and I am very much biased, look at my shirt, but I really did think he did a great job in this movie. It's kind of rare to see Chris Pratt in a more serious role. He's usually the comedic, funny guy, but I thought he was really good in this movie. We also get to see his butt, like, twice. Ah! Kill me now! I'm so weird, oh my gosh. Jennifer Lawrence was also great in this movie, as to be expected, and their chemistry was just great. I mean, I think it was kind of expected that they would have good chemistry on screen together. Another thing I really liked about this movie is how much it makes you think. There's a lot of questions that you're gonna have when watching this movie, and afterwards you're gonna wanna talk about it with someone and just kind of think, man, what would I do in this situation? And I love movies that make me think that. I saw this movie with a bunch of my friends, and afterwards we were just talking about it nonstop. And I love a movie that makes me think and makes me just want to talk about it with my friends, and that's exactly what this movie did. The visuals were also fantastic in this movie. There was only one really small thing where I was like, oh, that looks a little noticeable, but everything else just looks so real and authentic, and I felt like I was in a new world. It was just such a beautiful movie. Morten Tilden's direction was really good. He made one of my favorite movies of 2014 called The Imitation Game, so I really expected no less from him. Another thing that I really liked about this movie was the score, which was made by Thomas Newman. Thomas Newman is such a great composer, and the music, I think, really added another element to this movie. Overall, this movie just had a lot of great talent behind it. It had a superb cast and crew, and it just had everything going for it. But unfortunately, I feel like it had the potential to be even better. Like I said earlier, the premise was really promising. I mean, just the idea of these two people who are supposed to be asleep for 120 years but wake up 90 years too early is a really interesting concept. And I think this movie could have been one of the best movies of the year if it went in a different direction at parts. I really loved the first act, and I also enjoyed the second act, but I feel like the third act was a little rushed and kind of anticlimactic. The parts that I felt were anticlimactic were all of the parts dealing with, oh, the ship is gonna crash, what do we do? And it just wasn't as thrilling and dramatic as I wanted it to be. However, I really enjoyed the parts that followed Chris Pratt and Jennifer Lawrence's struggles through their inevitable death, and I thought it was just a really captivating idea, and I was enjoying that part. And I think for the most part, all of that was handled really well. Except I do wonder if there was a different order that the story could have been told in, that I think maybe would have impacted the audience in a different way. I don't want to spoil anything, but I feel like if something that was told in the beginning was told later on, maybe the movie would have been better. There is a moral dilemma at the center of this movie, and I really enjoyed that because, again, it's something that made me think and something that made me wonder, would I do the same thing or what would I do differently? It's just something that I feel like could have been tweaked in editing in order to maybe make things a little more surprising. I just wanted more out of this movie. There's nothing terribly bad about it, but nothing like, wow, this is such an amazing movie, and that's just what was disappointing about it for me. It's also a bit cheesy and follows these cliches, so that's something that some people might be like really turned off by, but I was fine with it. I really can't describe it better than by saying this had the potential to be even better and unfortunately doesn't follow this promising premise. It was overall an enjoyable movie that I would recommend to people who were initially interested in it. But I will say that if you have seen the trailers, you should be expecting something a little bit different from what is told on the surface, but that's all I'll say. I'm going to give Passengers a 6.5 out of 10 and see it in theaters because, again, the visuals are just fantastic, and I mean, who doesn't want to see Chris Pratt's butt on the big screen? Just me? No? Thank you guys so much for watching my review. If you enjoyed it, please let me know how you felt about it in the comments below and tell me what you think about Passengers. I know a lot of people are really nailing this movie and saying it's terrible, but I highly disagree with that. It's not amazing, but it's not terrible either. I'm sorry about the lack of reviews on my channel lately. With school, I've just been really busy and it's hard to make more quality videos, but I have been able to make some reaction videos just because those are really easy to throw together. So if you're interested in those, I'll put them in the cards up here. There's one for Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, and I'm sure you can tell by now that I really like Chris Pratt, so you can go check that out if you're interested. But yeah, that about wraps it up for this review. Please subscribe if you'd like to see more of my videos, and I'll see you in the next one. Got this huge gust of wind, dang.